There are a bewildering amount of feeder rods available to the angler. But what if you're on a tight budget and just want one rod that does it all, a jack of all, one size fits all, the Swiss Army knife of feed rods? Is there such a thing? Now, if you're a regular Angling Times reader or a viewer of this channel very often, you will have seen me test quite a lot of feed rods, from really expensive distance models to shorter, much cheaper graphite models. But the facts are, most anglers just want one rod to go feeder fishing. My old man would have not wanted more than one rod. He would have wanted a rod he could go to the river with, to a lake with, caught carp with, caught bream with. He was just interested in one rod. He wouldn't have wanted to spend a lot of money on it, and it would have had to last him a long time. So with that in mind, this is Shakespeare's SKP Solitude. And we've looked at quite a lot of Solitude rods, but this is basically the 12-foot feeder version. And as an all-rounder, it comes as close to being a jack-of-all that I've seen for a long time. Now, this isn't the first time you've had the Solitude to the bank. We came out with it last week and we went to Beastie Lake, where we used it with bread tactics. We fished right across the lake as far as we could, so at some distance, and we caught a big carp and we caught a few F1s. But today we thought we'd bring it to a smaller lake and have a look what it's like at short range. I was impressed with it at long range. It can certainly handle sort of 40 gram casting weight. But let's see how it gets on with some close quarter tactics. We're going to cast across, not very far, so there's short casting distances, and we're going to use lighter lines and smaller hooks. So it's the first bite of the day. We've got like an 8mm wafter on, and we've cast it across to the corner of the lake. And as you can see, this is a 12-foot length. This should be, as an all-rounder, it's definitely the preferred length. And I'll tell you for why, because should you need to cast, like we did on Beastie Lake, if you should need to cast that little bit further, it has got the potential to cast quite a long way. You have to be it's a bit tricky with shorter distances, but it's not impossible. As you can see, this rod, it's got a nice enough action. It's quite powerful. It's definitely a progressive action, but you would certainly get away with sort of decent sized bream and skimmers. It would make a really nice sort of block ender for the Thames or the Avon. So it pretty much has got an all round use. So this is a commercial. I mean, one of the most famous commercials. I don't know if this is an F1 or a half decent carp, but there's no flat spots. It comes with three quiver tips, I think, 1 ounce, 2 ounce, and 3 ounce. And the white ends, if you're a match angler, you probably scowl at that. But if you go to the river and you sit with the rod up in the air for barbel or chub, then white is much better. So we're certainly in control of this fish. It has got quite a lot of poke down bottom end. And there it is, first one of the day. So we're playing another carp. The truth is, I found the 12-foot length and the sturdiness of this rod to be a little bit too much for a venue of this size. The two-piece 12-foot rod, they're normally a little bit softer than the three-piece design. The three-piece design allows the designers to put quite a lot of power in the butt and in the second, and then they make the carrier section that has a quiver tip in it that bit softer. But this one is quite a powerful rod for a two-piece design, but would be very nicely suited for rivers and bigger waters than this. But you get away with it for this, and at its price, and I think you can sort of, if you shop around, you'll find it for under £70. It really represents a good all-round bargain feeder rod. We've talked before about the Solitude's look, the olive green blank with the little gold whippings on it. It's very retro, and I think probably anglers will find it a bit Marmite, but I quite like it. There's nothing wrong with an old-fashioned type of rod, and me dad would love it, and that's quite important to me.